Hi. Welcome to the show. I'm not even sure where we are, but this is 142.
Something like that.
Yeah. We're trying to film a lot of shows because I'm away in Austria for the whole of February.
That's right.
And so last week we did the excellent, we thought it was excellent, 80s rap special part one.
Yeah, that's right.
We're going to bookend that with a part two, but in between we're going to have three 80s shows.
Yeah, early, middle, mid and late. Yeah. That's right. And no hip hop.
Yeah, so that's right,
and nothing. Well, there might be a few funky surprises in there, but basically, this is actually just 80s stuff.
Yeah, it's weird. Starting with the excellent Dexys Midnight Runners Gino, which
that's right. Yeah, right at the beginning of 1980, this one came out, and I remember loving it when I was a kid. Yeah. All of you younger viewers out there probably wouldn't even remember this track, but hey. It's a killer, it's absolutely brilliant. But yeah, it's a bit of a departure for us, you know, because we have sort of like slid into a bit of a pigeonhole really and the sort of stuff that we actually play. So I've got two Bradas, two sort of like sections down there of stuff that I actually just like that happened to me sort of like when I was growing up and stuff. So that's what we're going to be concentrating on. Probably going to lose a lot of you after this one song, but hey, try and bear with us, Sarah.
Bear with us, you might like Zang in the next few shows.
Yeah, you might.
Anyway,
because next up we've got one from Brad and the lovely Lynx. Yeah, wicked little track this.
Lynx, and this is Together We Can Shine. That's what me and Chris said to each other last
time. Yeah, exactly, yeah.
That was me.
You're number one, Brad.
Oh, you're number two, Chris. Oh, yeah. I like it when I slow this down. It's cool.
It's an excellent beat.
It's a wicked beat.
It's really dusty fingers.
You might hear this on a certain little
You might tape. Hear it on a certain beat tape.
I don't know what's going on with that, so it might be out already, who knows?
You never know. Yeah, this is killer, this is. And there's a track on the other side as we were just flicking through that I did not know what it was, and it was actually sampled later on in the 80s or even in the early 90s in some wicked hardcore tune. So, yeah.
Anyway, the album's called Intuition. My links and it was 982.
You'll probably see it in many places and you pick it up really cheap.
Yeah,
it's really good.
It's cheap, yeah. It's good. Mine was 99p.
There you go.
Anyway,
moving on. What have we got next? Oh, a little bit of an 80s classic coming up now. But you can't deny that Hall & Oates were damn well cool, especially their hair and the moustache.
Yeah.
Anyway, let's go.
Yeah, for me, one of the great tracks of the 80s.
Totally.
Yeah. I love Hall & Oates, man. I love that Daryl Hall. If you never watched that Alive from Daryl's House, it's in Guyans, it's about 2007, you've got to watch that. It's brilliant, man.
Yeah.
People jamming. Just
cool.
Excellent. But,
and this is a quality track. This is a sample by De La Soul as well.
Yeah. And it's written, this track was written because of a mistake.
He
left him a note saying, I can't go for that, or it was like, I can't go for that, or say no go. But it was written wrong.
Oh, okay.
And he saw it on the side when the what I'd like to know is what we're doing in the same hotel room together. But
isn't there one of their front covers of their album when they in bed together or something like that?
I don't remember.
Or is that Morecambe and Wise?
Yeah. But it's a great track, man.
Yeah, it's brilliant.
It's one of those tracks everybody loves.
Yeah.
You know, it's one of those ones that doesn't matter how popular it is, and there's very few tracks like that.
No.
Yeah.
That's right.
This and Only the Fastest Movement in the West.
Yes. Well, it bloody was. Benny Hill was a genius.
Obviously, I would be Daryl Hall, he would be John Oates, going like this now. Oh, you got a very little moustache, Chris.
Well, all I need to do is just shave this off.
Me and Vicky said if we went to an 80s fancy dress party, she would go as John Oates and I'd go as Daryl Hall.
So you really would be fucking
in that night. You should have seen when I was looking when we did the cop show one the other week, and I was looking for pictures of Starsky and Hutch. There is a fetish out there of making beautiful paintings of Starsky and Hutch having sex. There is literally dozens of pictures of it, and some of it I say is beautiful.
Man,
but they're ruining my childhood because they weren't together. Anyway,
just like Magnum.
I can't go for that.
Anyway. Next up, we've got a bit of a popping sort of classic. Let's go. Yeah, any of you over a certain age would have definitely remembered popping and locking to this one. I think it was sampled maybe 10 years ago. Is it Naz who sampled it? I think so, or someone like that. Anyways. Yeah. Sorry, that was a bit of a dad dance then.
That's what it looks like.
Yeah,
that's
Thomas Dolby, She Blinded Me by Science. Lovely track, man. Yeah, it's killer.
There you go.
Anyway. Before it goes into the sort of singing bit that kind of detaches it from this, we're going to go to a bit more sort of a boogie sound, but still 1980, so early 80s as we go through this. And it's the Dells coming out next, and it's a killer track. Yeah, this is the Dells, All About the Paper from 1980. Great little boogie. I think it was on that Boogie Tunes comp or something like that, or one of those. It's brilliant. It's a bit of me, this. Certainly a bit of Martin Lovegrove, I reckon.
Oh yeah, he'll be on this, yeah.
Actually, there's a song coming up in the probably next week that he'll really love. Yeah, it's so good.
Yeah, we haven't, again, like last week, we haven't tried to pick, we'll pick the best tunes that we can get. This picture, we literally had piles of stuff. I bought a big bag over, we bought some bags, like dragging stuff out. And that's how we ended up with three shows, but
that's
only seven tracks on these because
I've
got rid of these all go away.
Exactly.
And plus, you get sick of 80s tunes that we did.
You will do, so 3 weeks of them, but at least they are, you know, a bit different.
And if we'd have had to pick 80s film soundtracks every week, we'd have been here for 4 days.
Forthcoming, that one.
Yeah, that'd be good, man. Anyway, coming up next, we've got a brilliant track, something completely different.
A bit of, so I would call it Psychobilly, but it's certainly probably one of my favourite albums. It's by a group called The Gun Club. Anyway, so here is Six Beat.
Yeah, this is The Gun Club and
Six Beat.
Six Beat.
Oh yeah, you know, you can't help but like other styles of music, can you really? And as much as I collect funk, jazz, soul and everything like that, and everything weird and obscure and stuff, I love this sort of shit, I can't help it.
It sounds like that secret Bob Dylan and the Clash album.
Totally, yeah, from Los Angeles in On Heroin. Yeah, fucking awesome.
Yeah, Sex B. It says something about Chris that this is his Sex B.
Totally.
What's your Sex B? What's your
do it too.
I like to do it to the Muppet Show album.
Love it, absolutely love it.
Yeah, he wanted soft sellers.
You're lucky, we nearly did play soft sellers.
Chris has been doing this a lot and this a lot, which I can only describe as
fisting. Yeah, anyway, so we've only got one track left because it's a super short show this week.
Yeah.
But yeah,
quick ones.
Totally love this. Anyway, so the next step. Ah, well. It's actually, we could have played one of the famous ones off of this album, no. There's a killer little song on the Adamant's first album, well I say first major album anyway. So here we go. Yeah, I love this album.
Yeah, that's good. That's got some good stuff.
Fucking
man.
Brilliant. If you like this,
in music,
if you like this, listen to The Cramps as well. They're very, very similar.
I didn't know The Cramps though. Either you've played them to me before.
They did a wonder.
Or I've had a nasty case of cramps.
They did one song
is
on
that crabs.
Yeah. They did one
neither,
song
neither.
On. There's a one song on that Return of the Living Dead.
Oh, okay. Adam and the Amps, local lads.
Ant Invasion.
But this is, I didn't remember this. I remember the album so well as a 9-year-old.
Well, my sister had it when I was a kid, yeah. And I remember playing it all the time, and I love this one because it's moody.
But yeah, I just didn't remember it, but it's so cool, man.
I think Adamant is cool, I have to say.
Yeah.
He went a bit bonkers, but hey. He's back on here. He had an album out last year, and I heard a few bits and bobs, sounded alright.
But anyway, yeah.
It's excellent. Anyway, that's it from us this week. That's our 7 tracks up anyway. And
I've quite enjoyed having a quickie.
Yeah, we're here, me too. See you soon. More often than not, that's what happens these days.
See you next week with some more fisting from Chris.
Totally.
See ya.